Hey, so good morning everyone. Welcome to Technology Home Economics online class. So we are now in lesson 2 of the fourth quarter, measuring dry and liquid ingredients. I am Miss Mary Ann Fonte, your teacher for today. Accurate in measuring baking ingredients produces good quality products. Behavior of ingredients when combined in a recipe is not only dependent on the kind of ingredients used but also on the amount of these ingredients. Measuring the right amount of ingredients depends largely on using standard measuring tools and the correct technique in measuring so that accuracy is obtained. Okay, so here are the standard table of weight and measures. So 1 tablespoon or T or TBSP is equal to 3 teaspoons. So 2 tablespoons is equivalent to 1/8 cup. And then 4 tablespoons is equivalent to 1/4 cup. 5 1/3 tablespoon is 1/3 cup. 3/4 cup plus 2 tablespoons is equal to 7/8 cup. Then, 16 tablespoons is equivalent to 1 cup. And 2 cups is equal to 1 pint. Then, 4 cups is equivalent to 1 quart. Then, the last is 16 ounces is equivalent to 1 pound. Okay, so let's have an example. Convert the following. So number 1, 6 tablespoons is equivalent to how many teaspoons? So we all know that in 1 tablespoon, we have 3 teaspoons. So what we are going to do is we have to multiply 6 times 3. So 6 times 3 is equal to 18. So the answer is 6 tablespoons is equivalent to 18 this one. Okay, another example. So, blank tablespoon is equal to 10 cups. So, what are we going to do? So, we have 16 tablespoons in 1 cup. So, we have to multiply 16 times 10 cups. So, 16 times 10 is equal to 160. So, meaning to say 160 tablespoon is equal to 10 cups. So, in 10 cups, we have 160 tablespoon. Okay, so let us proceed to the oven temperature. So, here's our temperature conversion table. Okay, oven temperature, here are the Fahrenheit and the Celsius and the temperature. So, when the Fahrenheit is 250 and the Celsius is 120, meaning to say the temperature is very slow. And then, if the temperature of our oven is 300 degrees Fahrenheit and the degree Celsius is 150, meaning to say the temperature is slow. Then 325 to 350 degrees Fahrenheit and 160 to 180 degrees Celsius, meaning to say the temperature is moderately slow. Then 375 to 400 degrees Fahrenheit and 190 to 200 degrees Celsius, meaning to say the temperature is moderate. Then 425 to 450 degrees Fahrenheit and 220 to 230 degrees Celsius, so the temperature is moderately hot. Then 475 to 500 degrees Fahrenheit and 250 to 260 degrees Celsius, meaning to say the oven temperature is hot. How will we convert Fahrenheit to Celsius? So what is the formula? The formula is degree Celsius is equal to degree Fahrenheit minus 32 times 5 divided by 9. So let's have an example. Convert 41 degree Fahrenheit to degree Celsius. First thing to do is we need to know the given and the formula. So 41 minus 32 is equal to 9. So 9 times 5 is equal to 45. So 45 divided by 9 is equal to 5. So meaning to say, 41 degree Fahrenheit is equal to 5 degree Celsius. How about Celsius to Fahrenheit? How will we convert it? So we have to know the formula. So the formula is degree Fahrenheit is equal to degree Celsius times 9 divided by 5 plus 32. So here is an example. So convert 5 degrees Celsius to degree Fahrenheit. So 5, which is the given. So 5 times 9 is equal to 45. So 45 divided by 5 is equal to 9. So 9 plus 32 is equal to 41. So meaning to say, 5 degrees Celsius is equal to 41 degree Fahrenheit. Let us now proceed to the measuring dry and liquid ingredients accurately. Is it important to measure dry and liquid ingredients accurately? Yes, of course. So the first thing that we need to do is we have to know the materials. So we need the dry ingredients, like for example, the flour, granulated sugar, brown sugar, baking powder, soda, and cornstarch. The second one is we have the liquid ingredients like water, milk, oil, and others. Number three, of course, this is very important in measuring dry and liquid ingredients, which is the measuring tools. So like for example, the graduated measuring cup, measuring spoons, weighing scale, individual measuring cup. And then others, we also need to use the spatula, the tray, and the sifter. Okay, so here are the steps in how to measure dry and liquid ingredients accurately. So let us begin with the dry ingredients, which is the flour. So how will we measure a flour? So the first thing that we need to do in measuring a flour is sift the flour. So using the sifter. The second one is scoop to fill the measuring cup to overflow. We don't need to shake it. Then the third one is level up with spatula. If we don't have a spatula, we can also use the back edge of our knife. Next ingredients that we have is the sugar. So we have two different kinds of sugar. We have the white sugar and the brown sugar. So in measuring white sugar, the first step is sifting is not necessary before measuring unless it is lumpy. Second, fill the measuring cup until overflowing. Do not shake the cup. And then the third one is level up with the spatula. The next one is the brown sugar. So there is a difference in measuring white and brown sugar. So the first step in measuring brown sugar is check if the sugar is lumpy before measuring. Rule out the lumps and remove the dirts. Then the second step, scoop into the measuring cup and pack compactly until it follows the shape when inverted. Next ingredients that we have is the powdered food or the baking powder and the baking soda. So the first step in measuring powdered food is remove the lumps in the powder by stirring. Second, dip the measuring spoon into the powder. And the third one is level with spatula or the back edge of the knife or right in the can opening. Shortening solid fats. So the first is fill the measuring cup, spoon with the shortening while pressing until it is full. Number two, level the fat with the straight of a knife or a spatula. Liquid fats. First, pour oil in the glass measuring cup. Two, check if it is filled up to the measuring mark. Do not lift the cup when measuring. Next, milk. Liquid form. First, set the liquid measuring cup. Place the measuring cup on a flat oven surface. Second, pour the liquid carefully and slowly into the cup. Stop pouring when the liquid reaches the marker line for the desired amount. And then the last one is check your measurement. Bend down so that your eyes level with the marker line. Look at the top of the liquid. Powdered milk. First, remove lumps in powdered milk by stirring. Second, scoop lightly to fill the measuring cup or spoon without shaking until it overflows. And then the third one, use the spatula or the straight edge of the knife to level the measurement. Okay, so those are the steps on how to measure dry and liquid ingredients accurately. So the question is it important to measure dry and liquid ingredients accurately? Yes, of course. So measuring dry and liquid ingredients accurately is important to